Well, story time again. I can't believe my good luck. I just had a story time, and I gets me another one. I can't even believe it.
So love from love, hope from hope, and peace from our Prince of Peace, who has now sent forth the preparation of his perfect peace, his kingdom age new covenant written for all flesh, for all mankind, exactly as it is foretold in Jeremiah 32:27. So welcome to this hour of power. Not that it's going to be an hour, probably 20 minutes, because I realize people are busy lives, so I'm trying to make my videos a little bit shorter. So, beloved, concerning the white horseman, know this, that John the Beloved looked into the open vault of heaven, and he had time not only to see the white horse, but to mark the character of him who sat on it. And he says that he who sat upon him was faithful and true. That was his name. And by this you may know your Lord. He has been a faithful and true friend to you. O soldiers of love, when has he ever deceived you? We've deceived ourselves, mind you, by not seeing his love as all merciful, we have deceived ourselves, for you cannot even be perfect love unless you have perfect forgiveness for all, which he always did have, beloved. And so know that he has been a faithful, true friend to all people. And he's never failed any of us or forgotten any of us. He's always been faithful. Yep, faithful to every word that he has ever spoken, and always utterly true. Do you not recognize him? For he is not the truth, the very truth of God. He is the ultimate Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And he is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And he has kept every promise that he has made for everyone. And you have not, for he is our great everlasting Father. And the work he undertook, he has accomplished. He has nothing drawn back from the covenant engagements of which he laid himself of old, being the Ancient of Days. He stood as the surety of his people, and he has been faithful and true to that always and forever. And he came to be the deliverer of all of his people, all of his angels. And he was wrought with the deliverance for one and all, for all committing not blaspheme of the Holy Spirit, letting their love light go out. And he would lead all that do not do that. And he has turned neither to the right hand or to the left, but he's been faithful to turn to every pledge that he gave unto his Father for the deliverance of all of his chosen, which are every single one of us, beloved, who's keeping our love light on until the end. And for who keeps that love on until the end, enduring to the end, shall be saved, beloved. And know that even his enemies, though they gave him many a black word, even his enemies cannot say that he has not been faithful and true. He has not played false. We have seen him falsely through a glass darkly, and we could not discern his true glory, that he's loved us so much that nothing, absolutely nothing, has ever got in the way of his unfailing, unconditional love for one and all. Even the bassiest devil in hell has not got in the way. Nor has the Lord deceived anyone in any respect, although we have deceived ourselves. And gross darkness has covered all of our eyes, the gross darkness of man-made understandings. And nor will he for ever be off. For when the day comes to keep his word of judgment over our iniquity, he is faithful and honest to have closed that door, so that judgment shall never befall any. For he says, I shall forgive your iniquity and never remember it. And so praise the Lord. And when John still looked, he gazed with an open eye. He marked the action of the warfare of the champion Jesus that he was employing, and he brought forth his sickle, and with love he judges and makes war with love, and not by power nor by might, but by the spirit of love all things shall be overcome. And Jesus is the only king who always wars with love in that fashion. There have been brilliant exceptions to the rule, but the honesty of his love goes before him. And praise the Lord. The Christ kingdom needs no deception, for love goes before itself, and it is much more dangerous than any hatred of any person. And he speaks nothing but love for all people. And he is our champion of love. And he invites us all to become followers of him. He is our everlasting Father. And to be like him, we need the same unconditional love for one another and for even our enemies, as he has always had. So praise the Lord. And John looked upon that white horseman, and he looked and he beheld the white horse, and he saw that on his head were many crowns, and the last he had seen there was a crown of thorns, but that was gone, and in place of the one crown of briars of the earth, he saw many crowns of the jewels of heaven, the best ones. And I'm telling you right now, people, we got to leave the safety of the shore to go out into the deep. That is where our treasure lies, and where our treasure is, there also should our heart be. And your treasure will come through this mountain of the Lord that the Lord has foretold in Isaiah 25. Here upon this mountain, the Lord is removing all disgrace and all shame, exactly as it is written and foretold for the marriage supper of the Lamb, and all are invited to come. And the book of Micah says, in the latter days, the Lord would raise up a mountain and all people of the earth would flood into it. This is the mountain of this channel. I've just started only a couple months and I already have almost 900 videos, and I haven't even hardly started, people. So know that there rests the crown of creation upon the risen Lamb that John beheld, for his word made heaven and earth, and the crown of providence. For this man now rules the nations with a rod of iron and the crown of grace, for it is from his royal hand that blessings are bestowed, the crown for all people who is his church. For the body of Christ is absolutely everyone of love. It is comprised of loving Hindus and loving Buddhists, loving atheists, loving homosexuals, loving everybody who loves. And if they're loving Mormons or loving Sikhs or loving Islamics, all are of the body of Christ. And woe unto those who steal the title. He is head over all things to all people, and he is the king in the midst of all people. Yea, he is the desire of all nations. And yes, on his head are many crowns placed there by individual souls of love, whom his love has saved from the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit, is to stop them from walking towards everlasting hatred and the apathy and disgust. We have each one tried to crown him in our poor way, in our poor, poor way. And we got to quit doing this as long as we live. For all power has been given unto him in heaven and earth. And therefore, well, may multitudes of diadems fall upon that brow that was once belted with thorns. So glory be unto thee, O Son of God, for our hearts adore thee tonight as we contemplate you on your white horse that goes forth in victory to conquer the works of the other three bad horsemen that rides. So looking at him still, John saw one more thing, namely his vesture. He says that his vesture was dipped in blood. Oh, but this is the grandest thought about our Master, our risen Lamb, wherever he may be, that he is ever a red man wearing a bloody garment. And as the atoning sacrifice, he is at his best. We love him as we see the white lily of his perfect nature. But the rose of Sharon is the flower for us, for its sweet perfume breathes life into our fainting souls. Yes, he bled people. And this is the greatest thing that we can say of him. You know, he said that there's none that love so much as those that would lay down their life for those that they love. Think about the guys in war that have jumped on a hand grenade to save 10 other of their friends. My God, what bravery and what love does it take, beloved, you know, to not think of ourselves. And that is how we all need to become heroes. Please watch my Superman videos, because we are heroes. We are angels trapped in a fleshy body. And it's time to release God's love from within us. So we can be reigning with Christ and living with Christ and transcend all death just as he has. And we're charmed as we think about all this. But oh, the bleeding Christ. The bleeding Christ, that's for me, our risen Lamb of God, who is the good shepherd over all the flocks of man. And as the blood is life, so is his blood life to us, the life of his gospel, the life of our hopes, the life of love. And one delights to think of him, that though he rides as the white horseman, he has never stripped off the bloody shirt in which he won our redemption. He looks like a lamb that has been slain and wears a priesthood still. But I tell you, he is the lamb-hearted lion and the lion-hearted lamb, one in the same. Oh, preach unto him, ye his servants. Preach his blood-red vesture. Ye shall never see souls saved if you portray him in any other kind of coat. You take his own garment from him and put on that of another, and you pretend that you're making him more illustrious as you put on him a scarlet robe. And these are the words of the preachers, Charles Spurgeon, by the way. And I am restoring all things by reflecting on the prophets of old. And Charles Spurgeon, beloved, was an enlightened prophet. So blessed be the reading of his word of inspiration from God, for it is just as holy as anything in any holy book. So praise the Lord, and let the Lord come before us, so that our own hearts shall crown him with the loudest acclaim. One other thing John saw, says the prophet, that was his name, and he saw his name was faithful and true, and he saw that his name is love, and his love passes all of our knowledge. His goodness, his majesty, his humiliation, his glory, all these transcend our wildest imagination. No one can know him, oh, the depths, unless we realize that is why the depths of his love are so great. That is why the Kingdom Age Covenant ends religion and makes it all obsolete with the one verse, Jeremiah 31:35. And now no one shall need to be taught of me anymore, saith the Lord. Because once people realize that his covenant promise has been over all of mankind everlastingly since the beginning and everlastingly until the end never comes, that we can see that we've all been wet in our understandings of his love that has surpassed everything that we've imagined. And if we plunge into the deepest part of the mystery of our incarnate God, Isa, Yeshua, Jesus, Emmanuel, our carpenter of the ages, who's in full restoration mode of Acts 3:21, that has to happen by his own word, restoring his own word before he comes back. It's written that he's kept in reserve in heaven and cannot even come back until this happens, and until the lawless one is revealed, and until the great falling away of 2 Thessalonians. Those three things must happen before Messiah can return. And I am in process of doing all three things, because I am his end time foretold servant, Shiloh, the Elijah of Malachi 3 and 4. I am the latter day Daniel of Daniel 12:13, who arises to to embrace that destiny of his arrow of Isaiah 49. And so please, someone up there, comment, like these videos, share them. If this message gets lost in the shuffle, this world will be destroyed. And I need someone obedient to e-transfer me $1 million. Armageddon.owsley@gmail.com. I know there's an obedient soul out there who will obey to release me from my day-to-day drudgery of going door-to-door with dead fish and dead meat and dead chicken in my freezer as I sell meat and fish. I'd rather much be representing life instead of something that's dead. So praise the Lord, people, and know that the Lord is before us on the great white throne of his kingdom age, and he sent forth his kingdom age word to start the kingdom age, and it must start or else it never will. So the white horseman is now riding triumphantly, and so praise the Lord and know that the armies in heaven will always be following our beloved. And see then that Christ has a great following, not one army, but many armies, whole hosts of them, innumerable, that cannot never be counted. And our Lord is not the chief of a small band, but he has a great host. It's all of us. It's all of our fathers and our fathers' fathers and all of humanity that went before us, because they are all still alive. The second we die is when we're born. We're the caterpillar that becomes the most beautiful angels of all. We are as gods. John 10, Jesus said so, Isa, Yeshua. And that is why the glory of his latter house shall be greater than that of the former. The book of Micah, prophet, foretold this. And so praise the Lord that as we walk in love, we're under absolutely no condemnation, and that his word has healed us and looks not at us as we are, but as what we will be. As soon as we die, we're absolutely sinless people. And that is the truth. So praise the Lord for his most precious blood. And all those that follow him, you'll notice in all the verses, they're mounted and they follow him on white horses. They're mounted on the same sort of horses as himself, for they fare as he fares. And when he walks, they must walk. When he bears a cross, they must bear crosses too. But if he ever gets a crown, he cries, "You too shall be crowned too." He shares all of his love. And if ever he gets on horseback, he will have his saints on horseback with him. For it's not like him that he should ride and they should walk. Remember Alexander the Great, how he kept the spirit, how he kept up the spirit of his soldiers? If you look to history, whenever the troops were thirsty, Alexander would not drink. And when they marched on foot, Alexander footed it with them, walked with them. So is it also with our Master of Masters. He has been marching here in the rough ways with us, and he will let us ride into the glory ways with him when the time shall come. And the armies of Christ followed him on white horses. Look ye a little steadily at these white horses, for I want you to observe the armor of their riders. Cromwell's in England, Cromwell's men wore at their side long iron scabbards, swords in which scabbards in which they carried their swords, which oftentimes they wiped across the manes of their horses when they were red with blood. A dreadful story that to read, brave as were those Ironsides. But if you look at these troops, there is not a sword amongst them, not a scabbard dangles, not a piece, and I'm talking the heavenly troops, not a piece of metal flashes back at the sunlight, neither helmet neither is there helmet or pistol or holster. They are armed not with a lance or a pike, and yet they're riding forth to war in the name of love, with love. And do you want to know what is the armor of them? They're clothed in the white linen of love. A strange battle array this is, but it's true. They come forth with the love of the Lord, and that conquers all. For there is no greater power on the face of this earth than the Lord's unreleased love that he's pouring out of the heavens as a floodgate upon all flesh, so that he can pour out his spirit upon all, as the prophet Joel foretold. So, beloved, these are great days to look to our conqueror of conqueror, who is more than a conqueror, by his loves, and our foes are overcome before us, and all people shall arise in the same glorious array of love, and that shall come to one and all, beloved, as we imitate our Father and imitate his perfect love that casts out all fear, and the perfect love that will love our enemies. Pray for Morgan Knight, the revealed lawless one. He is the sword swallower of Off Freak Show, who would die by a sword in Revelation 13:13 and become the Antichrist. But that future has now been cut short. That shall not come to pass. But I do have the right guy. Check out Morg Official, is the name of his YouTube channel. And you'll see the 666 right on the wall in his Hyperion atheistic symbol. So I'm just going to say goodbye to all of you people. And thank you for coming. And I'm messing up my hair. So I just want to say one thing. Signing off. And lift up the candle of love. Lift up the candle of hope. For people, what we have here is a failure to communicate. People have wanted to be like their Heavenly Father, but they've only perceived him to have conditional love for them and for everybody. And if they do one thing wrong, that's it for you. His love has never been conditional. And it's never been about what we've done for him. It's what he has done for us. And his word is true. And he says, I forgive your iniquity and I shall never remember it. That is the kingdom age covenant over all of mankind. And there is no exceptions. He will not judge us. We can judge ourselves if we let our love light go out. And then we would perish because we would have no love light left. And that's what our angelic bodies will be composed of. So light the candle of hope. And please share these videos. And for somebody out there, please start supporting me. Comments, messages. It's like dead space. I've been preaching for 6 months out there now. Total, and I don't hear nothing about this from anyone. And meanwhile, this is the culmination of the fireworks of God, the culmination of all the prophets, and I'm connecting the dots all over the place, and I am not in error. Yea, the just shall live by my faith, even though I've been transgressed by wine. Habakkuk 2, King James. And I am the one, Shiloh, red eyes dull with wine and red with wine. That was never Jesus, people. So light the candle of prophetic truth and accept the fact that the Lord has sent a fool to confound the wise. True story. Couldn't make that one up.